Alright, welcome back to the fucking channel! May have started off a little bit intense, but I don't care. See this fucking explosion right here? There are two whiteheads here. There's one left, because it's a fucking dickhead. Like a little mole. White mole just buried in my nose. May have got a little off topic, and a tiny bit disgusting. But yeah, I haven't done a video like this since the Billie Eilish video, which actually got quite good feedback. So I thought, fuck it, I'll do it again. I've got nothing to record anyway. I'll probably have some Fortnite footage in the background. Just been playing the shit out of that game, because that game's actually been quite a lot of fun. Got Shaman on it, and Shaman is actually a really fun character. It's like Peacekeeper and Berserker just had a love child. That's pretty much Shaman. I've just started and I'm getting off topic. Fuck's sake. But yeah, what this video is going to be about, it's going to be about Battle Royales and how they're pretty much going to die. I mean, it's inevitable they're going to die, no shit. But I think a little bit sooner than like other genres of games. First of all, I'm going to give my opinion on Battle Royales and I really don't like them. Me personally, Battle Royale games are really, really boring now. When Fortnite was good in like Season 2, Season 3 days, that's when Battle Royales were good. That's when they were good. But now like Season 8 or whatever and fucking Apex Legends, it's kind of got a little bit ridiculous. There's a Battle Royale that's meant to come out that's about cars. Battle Royale. Huh? I saw some gameplay of it. You pick up like armor plating and then you got like a turret, which is meant to be an LMG and you can change the rarity. It's really fucking weird, but I just think it's oversaturated at this point. You know how earlier this decade, there was a shit ton of zombie shooters? Like the zombie genre was all the way fucking up here. And if you had a good zombie game, you were rich. But now you mention a zombie and you're down the fucking toilet. You see, Overkill's Walking Dead. Jesus. To be fair, though, it's not just zombies that made that game flop. The mechanics and shit in that game just made it fucking shit. To be fair, the zombie genre is actually making a comeback now. There's the World War Z one, Days Gone. I think there's supposed to be a Dying Light 2 that's supposed to be coming out, like, late this year. To be fair, there's reports of Dead Island 2 coming out by the end of this year. Yeah, so bad example, because zombie games are coming back very slowly. But to be fair, though, if they released it, I don't think it'd be, like, as popular as, like, Fortnite and shit right now. But yeah, back to the main point. Fortnite, I don't like it. Apex Legends, worse than Fortnite. If you want to dislike me, I wouldn't give a fuck. That's just my opinion. I'm not going to change my opinion for some 8-year-old kids that enjoy Battle Royale still. But yeah, so that's my opinion. But yeah, how I think Fortnite and like Apex Legends, like Battle Royale games will die, and I think it's the same way the zombie shooter died out. Like zombie shooters, there was a fuck ton of them. There were so many of them. And because of that, the market was oversaturated and people got really bored of them. There was nothing new. It was just the same fucking kill the dead person you killed last week. Dying Light was able to make a comeback with the whole like parkour aesthetic. To be fair, Dead Rising as a series. No. I was going to say Dead Rising as a series is actually still alright. But after Dead Rising 3, it's not been a good journey. Oversaturation is a big killer for many, many games. Think COD, right? COD, first-person shooters, fucking dominated the market for years. And now, who the fuck plays COD anymore? Yeah, Activision still gets millions from COD, but is it as good as, like, Black Ops 2, Black Ops 1? Obviously, it's not just oversaturation that affects those games, but you get the point. What do reviewers always say to, like, games like Advanced Warfare, Ghost, fucking even Black Ops 3? The same game every year, they don't change it up. To be fair, that's also a bad example, because the COD community hates change. The reviewers wanted a change in COD, they changed it, everyone hated it. Try and find a game in Advanced Warfare, I dare you. Thinking it's a Battle Royale, it's just the whole oversaturation thing. I'm gonna look up how many Battle Royales are gonna come out this year. Yeah, Apex Legends, Fortnite, PUBG, Black Ops 4's Blackout, Ring of... I don't know how the fuck to say that. Planetside Arena... No! No! Why is Planetside 2 getting a fucking Battle Royale? Battlefield 5, Battlestorm, Pavlov VR... Mavericks. Even Dying Light's getting a Battle Royale. You get the picture. There's a fuck ton of Battle Royales coming out. Sad thing is, 99% of those games won't sell. And that's because the market is dominated with Fortnite and Apex Legends. And the reason Apex Legends is even still around is because EA paid people like fucking Ninja to play the game on release. That's the only reason it's still alive. The game itself is shit. I'm sorry, you all know it's true. It's shit. See, what a lot of companies are doing now, they're cashing in just putting Battle Royale in their game. If they put Battle Royale in their game, guaranteed it's going to sell more. Because at the moment, that's trending. But the fact is now, most companies, they're just going for a quick cash grab instead of making an actual fucking good game. It might seem like I'm contradicting myself by saying like, oh yeah, they're going to get loads for this. But then I say everyone hates Battle Royales. Let me go into detail. So if you're my age, chances are, you fucking hate Battle Royales. If you're my age and above, you most likely hate these games. But, I'm not being offensive for this. if you're like 13 and under, chances are you're in love with Battle Royales. You're the kid who steals his mum's credit card to get some fucking V-Bucks for like a fucking dick weapon. I mean, obviously they wouldn't allow that because it's Peggy 3. But you get the idea. Kids are so impressionable and shit like that that when they see Battle Royale, they're instantly just like, "Mum, give me your fucking card, or as a matter of fact, I'm gonna take it from you." But little fucking Timmy, he just wants to pickpocket his mum's credit card, empty it out with V-Bucks, and there you go. No food for Timmy for about a year. But it wasn't always like this. Like, people like me, I really liked Fortnite and Battle Royale games back when, you know, it wasn't oversaturated. Back like early last year when Fortnite was getting big, no such thing as fucking Apex Legends, thank God. But the problem is, companies don't notice how we're not liking the game because of all the millions of kids that are still playing it. And as long as they can convince those millions of kids and little Timmy to buy their game because it's got Battle Royale in it, they're not going to stop. And because they're not going to stop, it's going to get oversaturated. A lot of companies, as a matter of fact, want to make money. They want to make the most money they can do. Surprisingly, I know. I don't think many people understand how saturation for a certain like market of games, like how badly that can affect. Think about a certain genre of games. Survival horror. Grab that, actually. Survival games as a whole. Rust. The Forest. Minecraft. Minecraft made it fucking huge, and then a lot of companies tried to copy it, and that's when it went downhill. When Minecraft blew up, a bunch of companies tried copying Minecraft by, like, trying to get in with a survival games genre. And as a result of that, Minecraft's fucking dead. The Forest is dead. Rust is dead. It's gonna be the same as Fortnite, and nothing's gonna stop it. It's the same fucking cycle. For the older people in the community, think of a game that was popular, like, back in, like, fucking 2000s. Think of the most popular game of that time. Think about what genre it was. And think about all the rest of the fucking companies that tried copying it. At the end of the day, it's the company's choice. It's a sacrifice they're gonna have to make. You wanna make a good game? Or make a cash grab? Be fair, think of fucking Tomb Raider. That blew up the adventure fucking game genre. That blew up the adventure game genre. And then look at Uncharted. Be fair, Uncharted is an exception to the rule because, in my opinion, that's better than Tomb Raider. I know a lot of people might just listen in and just not give a fuck. Like, I'm just a 16-year-old. What does he know? I'm just saying, from my perspective, it's not hard to notice these trends rise and fucking fall. Observe a game like Minecraft blow up, and then a bunch of companies following. Same with GTA. People might hate me for saying this, but look at GTA and then Saints Row. But to be fair though, Saints Row became a titan of a game franchise that it just stood on its own 2 feet. Without GTA's help. But yeah, that's just my opinion. That's what I wanted to share. Sorry if this video is a bit fucking boring. It's not all my videos are interesting anyway. But thank you guys so much for watching. If you did enjoy, leave a like on the video. It's always appreciated. As well as subscribing if you're new. And turn notifications on so you know when I upload. Share this video around with your friends. I don't fucking know. Share this video around with your friends. Teach them something. I mean, this isn't the most educational channel. Not exactly fucking free science lessons, am I? But yeah, I'll see you guys in the fucking bit. And don't play Battle Royales! I got that. I'm trying to move, middle.